dance.
Hey everyone, this is Aaron. I just want to make a quick video about what is safe and what is not safe. I know all you kids out there are probably doing some crazy things, and I want to give you some information so that you can be more safe and have more fun when you're doing them. So the first thing I wanted to cover is oral sex. You know, sucking the wiener, or eating the vagina, or rimming. Whatever the case, I want you to be safe whenever you're doing it. So these are a couple things that you should not do. First off, you don't want to floss at least 30 minutes prior to engaging in the activity. When you floss, it actually breaks the skin around the teeth with microabrasions, and that can cause an area where bacteria and semen and other things can be exposed to your skin and cause an exposure. The other thing is brushing your teeth. Again, 30 minutes before, you do not want to do this because whenever you brush your teeth, it causes the microabrasions that can you can be exposed to. Something that you probably don't think about is eating chips or eating other hard food that you have to crunch in your mouth that could cause those microabrasions in your mouth. And then whenever you're sucking someone's dick or whatever the case may be, and if they come in your mouth, then that semen is in your mouth and is able to, you're exposed to it through the microabrasions. Now the risk of contracting HIV through oral sex is very low. That's not zero though. There is still a potential. And with other things, gonorrhea, syphilis, herpes, some of these are able to be spread through skin-to-skin contact, like syphilis. So it's important to use protection. So you might want to consider using a condom if you're going to suck a dick, or if you're a female, using a female condom. And if you don't have a female condom, you could always get away with using saran wrap, okay? Kind of a home remedy. The next thing is lube. So we all use lube unless you use spit. And the one you need to use is water-based or silicone-based. These are both really good and what you should use with latex condoms. What you should not use is petroleum jelly or any petroleum-based lubricants. Why? Because it breaks down the condoms. And so when you do that, you're opening yourself up to a condom break and an unnecessary exposure. And so also we have these lube, these little trial packets. It's a good thing to have. You know, one thing that I have in my house is a flower vase, and it's full of the safe sex kits. It's full of lube, it's full of condoms. And I either put it on the back of my toilet in the bathroom. That way, you know, if I have a trick over, if I have someone over, they can look right in there and, you know, pick out what they want. Or it's in the closet, and so either my roommate or whoever wants something out of it, they can use it. Now, the other thing I want to talk about, and sometimes people don't want to talk about it, is poppers. And poppers is something that some people use. It causes vasodilation, so usually people that bottom or they're on the receiving end of sex will use these. They will inhale these, and it causes vasodilation, so it causes you to relax. Now, the problem with these is it does have a slight impact on your immune system, and then it also can cause you to put yourself into painful situations because you can't really feel the pain. So the thing I would say about these is be careful if you use them. Also, you would want to know that in the state that you're in, they are illegal in some states and they're not illegal in other states. So you'd want to know that. Another thing is, you know, so if you're going to bottom, you want to make sure that you're clean. You want to make sure everything's out of down there. However, be careful with this because your body actually has a natural defense, the natural mucus and the natural things. It's in your colon and in your butt. So if you're always doing this, you can actually open yourself up to more problems. And also, whenever you do this, you open yourself up to scraping the inside of your rectum, then if you have sex, exposing yourself that way. Now, the final thing is, some of you may have sex toys. And every so often, especially after every use, you need to make sure that you clean them. How can you clean them? The easiest way is putting them right here in the dishwasher. So whether it's cock rings, or whether it's toys, whether it's a dildo, whatever it is, you can put all these right in the dishwasher. Put a little detergent in there, clean it, let it dry, and you're good to go. If you have any questions, feel free to send me a question, and I will do my best to make a video on it. Till my next video, do something positive.